Welcome back to another vlog. It is officially October. We are faking it until we make it on the fall season because it is actually still 90 here. This week we are baking, we are reading, we are working on home projects. We're doing the same old, same old. The next couple of months are about to be very, very busy. So behind the scenes, I'm doing a lot of prep for that. But this week is a good, cozy, wholesome week. We're also leaving the house, which is huge.
Before we get into today's vlog, we're gonna do a little giveaway. We have my recipe journals here, here, and here. We're gonna pick three lucky winners to win recipe journals. All you have to do is subscribe to the House Guest YouTube channel, the podcast YouTube channel, and then comment below your favorite type of content you like to consume from me, and then I will pick the winners a week from today. Also, subscribe to this channel while you're here, and let's get started with the video. Good morning, Fitz. Good morning, Bub. Come here, Bub. You got it. Come inside. Come on. Literally no intention of doing that. Oh, he wants a belly rub. The tail wagging is killing me. Hi, y'all. Welcome back to another Week in My Life video. I am rushing out of the car because I'm going to the new Framebridge store. I'm going to the new Framebridge store in Dallas, and I'm so excited. I'm gonna get some stuff framed for the hosting closet and potentially just my house. And I'm filming a little like reel for them. But anyways, I'm ready for the day and I have my favorite bag. I'm so obsessed with this bag and I got another new charm and we're heading out. That store, like, oh my God, it was magical, okay? I got 9 prints for the hosting closet. I'm gonna start that collage wall. They're so amazing. I feel like framing normally sucks, but it was so easy. I ordered from Framebridge. This is not sponsored, by the way. I wish it was on the YouTube channel. I order from Framebridge a lot. I get people gifts on there. I order for myself. Like, I've done a lot of orders on there. Going in store was amazing, and I got like striped mats and cool frames. I love doing like creative things for my home like that, and I love that, and I want to do all of my Christmas gifts through there with like meaningful stuff. Like, I have old newspapers of my dad like playing sports when he was young. That would be cool to frame. Little notes, random stuff. And then they had like belt buckles framed. They had an actual belt framed. They had like license plates, napkins. I mean, like, so many things. Like, if you meet the love of your life and you're at a restaurant and you keep the napkin or something and they frame it and then have it in your house when you get married or something, that's so cute, you know? Anyways, I'm feeling so creative in the home. So I'm also gonna go to At Home because I do wanna find like a vase of some sort and just see if there's anything that I want for my little living room refresh. I do need to find a chair still. The rug arrived, but it's looking a little more green in person. I need to like take it out and see how I feel about it. I don't know yet. I don't know how we're gonna, I don't know. We'll have to see. We are going. I really want a pumpkin cream cold brew too. It's just feeling like fall. Today's October 1st. Love that. Back reunited. Oh my God, they're gonna have the Christmas stuff out too. I'm so excited. Cowboy Santa, that is so cute. Golf Santa is hilarious. These wicker trays, I have one, being $30 is actually insane. Like, that is such a good deal. I think I'm gonna get this, only $30. And then I would use this as the base for the greenery. So we'll see, it might not look good, but all of these are also great, but again, like, I like this. I don't know what I would put in it, but I like it. I hate that this is ripped because this would have been so fun to put in my closet. It's so fun. Here's my mini at-home haul. I got this to use as a vase for fake plants. It might not look good where I got it, so we'll see. And then I got this too. I don't know where I'm gonna put it, but it's a good like catch-all for keys, everything like that. And then for lunch, I picked up Keller's, which is my favorite burger. It's so good. I honestly think I like this more than the Hudson House burger. And you get a burger and fries for like $7. It's so crazy. If you guys live in Dallas, you know about Keller's. It's a classic staple. See, $7.79. They've never heard of inflation, and I'm obsessed with that. Also, y'all, I made an order myself for the new recipe. Why did I say myself weird? Also, y'all, I made an order myself for our new recipe journals. I do this every launch. Look at our cute little thank you card for your order. Love that. I'm actually gonna get all of our things and start framing them, like frame bridge. So one day, like when we have an office, every single like thank you card will be framed, which is cute. And then our two new recipe journals, if you guys haven't picked yours up yet, go order them. They're adorable. I'm so in love with them. Alright, so this isn't it. I just moved things around. Not all this stuff is gonna be here. I'm gonna move it. This might come down. We'll figure it out. I also really like this candle, by the way. Instant Karma from Sniff. This is not right. I need to mess with this and just see. And if not, I'll just order a new one and use those greens somewhere else. But it does confirm that I do want some sort of greenery over here. I just love this little corner of the house. It feels so cozy. I love the wicker basket with my blankets. Like, I love this. Wait, y'all, this actually kind of works perfect as a food tray. I'm kind of obsessed. Olipop root beer always. Little lunch.
Something was a little off that day. Looked more like a mountain to me, dreary, and any attempt unacceptable. Really wanted him to like me. Well, I stood there, which made me laugh, but I didn't move one inch.
All right, y'all, we are going to the ranch. Going riding this evening. I have my jacket from Everlane, tops Everlane, shoes are Tacovas, jeans are Abercrombie. I'm trying to make sure I'm doing things that like make me a happy person. And we are actually gonna try a new coffee shop too in like the Knox Henderson area. I haven't been yet. And apparently they have good like pumpkin spice things. I need a good fall drink, you know? I'm heading off. I haven't been to the ranch since like March. It's just so hot in the fall. Okay, we're off. Happy Wednesday. I just got ready in here for the first time. It's not what it's supposed to be, okay? I haven't actually redone any of this. I need to stain this. The mirror is going. This is all, it's just, you know, it's a work in progress. I am gonna wallpaper this closet, and this came in the mail. These are samples from Wall Shop. So I thought this was gonna be more pink, as if like that pink, but it's definitely more peachy. This one is a navy pinstripe, and they're supposed to be a matching fabric. It hasn't come in the mail, and the fabric I would have upholstered to this chair, but this would obviously go up on the wall. I just don't know if it's gonna feel too busy. Like, will that make me dizzy? I don't know, but I love the idea of the entire closet being wallpapered and really, really utilizing this space. So love, love, love that. I have to really decide. I have stuff for friendship braces over here, and I have to continue on. I was doing this as a project recently, and then I just kind of shut the doors to the closet, and I forgot about it. Like, this is the first day I've even used my vanity, just because I've been waiting to, like, have the place set up. So, anyways, I do think that that would be really cool, and I would do the entire closet, and then maybe have, like, specific boots or, like, something cool up there. And then I could always put seasonal clothing in like boxes up in the attic or something. So, or I could do baskets up here and then put the shorts up there, which is really what I should do. I just need to measure and get the right boxes. So anyways, home projects really are what gives me peace and joy. Little Free People haul, I will have it linked. Also, in case anyone was interested, I just posted, well, it's posting right now, but it's up now, a very long TikTok on like how to support your friend who is going through loss or grieving or something like that. Actually, not something like that. One of the two, it's the same thing. So really just how to support your grieving friend in the initial months, if anyone's wondering, or if anyone's interested, it's on TikTok. Okay, here's my little Free People haul. I've been loving Free People. First thing I got is this little set that I'll just wear around the house. I feel like I look so different in this stripe with my hair color. Like, I don't know what it is. I just feel like I look really, really different. So this morning I worked out and then I just been working from home, and now it is 12:30 and I've got lunch with Kate Davis, and then our friend Briley King is in town, so we're gonna go to Hudson House, and it's right next door to my needlepoint store, so like maybe I'll go there. Anyways, I have that. And then this jacket, it's black, so it feels a little harsh for me because I just don't typically wear black. But I, like, one thing about me is that I love a structured jacket as a top this season, and I feel like this is gonna be really good for something like holiday related too. I love this with like low-rise jeans and a loafer. I think it's so cute. But we have this, which I love. Oh my god. Okay, I don't know what I'm most excited for out of these next two jackets. I have this big, like, fringe brown suede jacket. It is so sick. This is honestly like what I should wear with the girls. We've got, it's so cute. I don't think this is what I'm gonna wear, but I love this jacket. It's so nice, and like for the price, it's actually, I got it in a large by the way, but for the price it's actually like really a really good deal for what it is. Then I got this jacket, and guys, like, this jacket is everything to me. It is, oh my god, like, this is what I'm wearing today. This with low-rise denim, it's so perfect. I'm in love. Very exciting news, I'm wearing the best outfit ever. My new jacket that I just showed y'all. $8 Target t-shirt, y'all know the drill. My favorite loose low-rise jeans, my favorite cowboy boots, the Josie by Jacobas. They don't sell these anymore, but they do sell the Jamie in suede, so if you guys want a suede cowboy boot, because suede is like it for this season. And one thing about me is that I've been on brown suede for years, right? Started with these boots, and they're my favorite. And then I have this bag, and yeah, sure. Is it 90 degrees? Probably. Who cares? It's literally none of my business. So anyways, I'm obsessed with this look. Gonna go take 15 different photos and get going by day. My god, it's amazing. Literally amazing, guys. There's nothing like a good outfit to boost your mood. These sunglasses. Hi, y'all. I'm back home. I'm on the phone with Macy for an hour and procrastinating. I need to get to work. I've realized I haven't been updating y'all on what I've been reading. I haven't been reading a ton. I've said that this year, for some reason, has been the hardest year for me with reading. I just cannot, like, get into a book that I really love. But the good thing is, a lot of books that I've been waiting to get released did get released on October 1st. I've become an Audible girly recently. I'm currently listening to Ina Garten's memoir, which released the other day, and that's very exciting. I finished last week Kelly Bishop's The Third Gilmore Girl. She's Emily Gilmore in Gilmore Girls, and it was good. I also started Lauren Graham's, but then Ina Garten's came out, and so now I'm listening to Ina Garten's. I really like memoirs on audiobooks, and I've really liked listening to it. And then let's see, like, what I've read the most recently. Oh, I did finish a thriller. Oh, I didn't even put that in my log. Okay. I finished Home Is Where the Bodies Are by Geneva Rose last week. Keaton recommended it to me. And she said it. She's like, it wasn't the best thing I've ever read, but it was good. And it was fine. Like, I definitely guessed what was gonna happen just because it's the exact same book as another book that I've read. By no means, out of like any thriller that you guys could read, do you absolutely have to read this book. I've only read 16 books this year, and normally at this point I've read at least like 50, at least. Like, I am so behind. I mean, I'm not even behind, whatever. Update on my hair journey, by the way. I took my extensions out, I went a little bit darker. There has not been a second that I have missed my extensions. I love having my natural hair. I love the coloring. It's just so much easier to take care of. It feels healthier now. having less to do with the extensions probably and more to do with the color and everything. But yeah, I love it for now. I love the look of the extensions, and my sister's really good at them, so I really never felt like they were a pain. Like, I was never the girl who like hated my extensions, but I just wanted to change, and I took them out so that my hair would be thinner, so that I would be more committed to staying on top of my hair care journey and like taking Nutrafol and doing my glimmer hair mask. And can you tell I'm friends with Kate Davis? Like, at lunch today I was telling Kate, I'm like, I'm literally you right now with my Nutrafol and my glimmer hair mask. But yeah, anyways, Briley, Kate, and I got lunch. It was really good, and I've just been back home after call. I'm not gonna do a mukbang. How do you pronounce that? I don't know. Because fun fact, like, if I hear someone chew, I want to scream. And the second someone starts chewing in a YouTube video, even if it's like my favorite person that I've watched in the past 10 years, I click off and it makes me want to scream. Like, oh my god. I have Musicopia. I'm trying to cover these lights. I ordered Dickies. I got a brisket sandwich. Barbecue sauce. Mac and cheese. And a straw for the drink that they forgot. When I order food delivery services, I feel like they forget the drink in like every order, probably because it's like in their cup holder and they just grab the bag, you know? So I should really just stop doing that as a whole. But anyways, I'm uploading all the podcast clips. This week's episode is with Kate Glavin. I'm covering all this. I love her so much. We had all about like one, how to become a runner, how to get into running. She's a marathon girly. And then we go really in depth on grief, on dating while grieving, on loss. She lost her dad, so we're talking more about like parent loss. It's honestly like a really beautiful conversation about life. Like, I really think anyone would like it. So if you guys are coming from this vlog, comment on it and comment Dickies, and we'll just see. Okay, I'm using this as my official food tray. These are the exciting things that happen in my life now. I have a food tray. Okay, all right.
If something goes wrong with your car, you can just pull it over on the side of the road mid-flight. Yikes. So I know what to do if the engine failed. My first solo flight was exciting, but also, when I was landing solo, I asked for permission to land.
Good morning, y'all. I got a facial, so my neck and my face is bright red, and because I got microneedling done, they like don't go around active breakouts, so it just makes it like more obvious. I went to Germani Preston Hollow, and it is the best. They have the subscription model, so it just saves you a lot of money if you want like Botox, filler, facials, laser hair removal. They literally have everything, and it's the best prices, and it's the best services that I've gotten. I like to get the hydrofacial followed by microneedling because it makes your skin glow like crazy. Obviously, you know, the redness takes a second to go down. Microneedling is amazing. It's helping with my lines on my neck, which is like my probably biggest thing that bothers me. I feel like I've been getting a lot of questions about my skin because my skin has definitely looked better in the last like year or so. And it is a combination of going to Germani and Preston Hollow and getting the hydrofacial followed by microneedling. Also, I do get dermaplaning a lot, which is just amazing. And then I also use like a ton of Primally Pure products, and those products are so good on your skin, and I just love it. I was actually thinking about that, you know, when you have like your winter uglies and you just feel awful, this is the way that I combat that, is the hydrofacial, and then if you can, microneedling. If you become a member, like you're the subscription model, you save so much money. So anyways, just wanted to share with my Dallas girlies. I also got my Botox there. I haven't gotten filler in a while, but like my sister gets filler there. Everyone else that I know gets filler there and loves it. And it's just amazing. So anyways, I'm back home. Macy's coming over. We're doing a little work from home cozy fall day. Slash, I'm really baking like 4 loaves of sourdough. I've never baked 4, but we're prepping at least 4 today. My first Christmas like order came in the mail today. I got these new kitchen towels from Anthropologie. I also got the Juice Icon glasses that I'm obsessed with. The way people are with Stanley glasses is how I am, or with Stanley's is how I am with the Icon glasses. My Christmas ones are gonna start to arrive very soon. I ordered them on pre-order like a month ago. Just on my starter, I'm toasting the last 2 pieces of sourdough toast, and it's gonna be a good day. I need to make another coffee. I'm really tired. Wow, I also have some needlepoint projects I want to finish. Like, it's just gonna be a good fall day. Y'all, I'm actually baking 4 loaves. Well, I'm prepping 4 loaves today. I'm in the middle of my stretch and fold, and I'm filming my like full tutorial on how I bake my sourdough with timestamps, the recipe, and everything. And I just transferred everything. Fun fact, not that anyone cares, sample coloring is different than mass printing. The mass printing is the correct printing. So you can see how the coloring is perfect here. Looks weird here. It's just for the sample. Anyway, I'm putting this back up here. Macy left. We made some fall pasta for dinner or for lunch. It was good. Okay, so I'm gonna use, this is my recipe journal that I use for everything. By the way, y'all can shop these. I'll link them below. It's pretty full. I use it literally all the time. But this one, it's so cute. I'm using this as my sourdough and discard one. So, I forgot to write that it's literally just sourdough and discard. But there's so many different recipes you can do, especially with discard. So, anyways, my two recipes. This is my standard sourdough. And this is a combination of a couple different recipes and techniques and stuff. So, I believe it kind of started as the sourdough mom's like 8 hour, and then I just kind of like morphed it into a better schedule for me. And then this is the pumpkin cinnamon swirl sourdough. This is a different recipe. That's why it gets a different one. For a lot of like my jalapeno cheddar, it's the same recipe. I just add this in when I'm folding, but, or not even folding, at when I'm shaping. Anyways, I just love this. I think it's so cute, and I wanted to share with y'all. So those are my current sourdough recipes. I've got SVU on. Here is the update on my facial. In the middle of this, I am prepping for the next launches of a friend of mine. If y'all are watching this, we'll start teasing it on our Instagram this week. And next week in the vlog, we are revealing the new product. And I'm very, very excited for it. But it's really just like a cozy fall day at home. So obsessed with Crown Affair. Day 2 of my facial, it's not as red anymore. Worked out, have Lowe's in the oven, and I'm trying to fix my hosting closet. So the wallpaper came down, it was from Spoonflower. It was peel and stick, most of my wallpaper is peel and stick, and it's worked out, but they sent me a replacement of like actual normal wallpaper. So that got fixed finally this week, and it looks a lot better. It's the exact same, but now I just need to update this. Those are samples of, sorry for my sourdough injury. Those are samples of the recipe binders and the different prints. We're not gonna continue on with them though, so don't get too excited. They're just gonna go up on this wall. Fixed, and then I also hung up the aprons. So much better, I don't have to worry about this anymore. And then my frames, once I get them back from Framebridge, we will hang them here, and it's gonna look insane. I'm so excited. God bless, look at you. We all contribute something.
Yeah, and it was scary.
Mm-hmm.
Mine was scary.
By the way, I'm eating the muffin, very good.
Wasn't it good?
Mm-hmm.
I've been on a protein pumpkin muffin recipe journey. I'm gonna write it in my recipe journal. Okay,
yes.
I'm so excited. I have been able to because both of the recipes I did before this were a flop, but can you try? You tried the bad one.
The hesitation there was insane.
It's good.
They're good, they're good.
Mm. It smells way better.
I know, the last ones were bad.
Mm. But she forgot her own recipe, to be fair.
I know.
So.
Thank God this is good. Someone DM'd it to me. She screenshotted it from
Thank
last
God.
Year. I tried to look back at my story archives, but I spam those stories, so it's hard to find.
I love when remote working turns into community working.
Mm-hmm. Macy's actually gonna make us lunch. It's a collaboration because Spencer, oh, where'd it go? Oh, he got.
I refrigerated everything.
Oh, wow.
Sharp cheddar, fresh from the.
It's gonna be really a lot. Spencer, what do you think about my new loaf? Are you gonna eat bread today? That's huge. Doesn't it look amazing?
That looks so good.
Yeah, but here's the issue.
What kind of cheese? How'd you put, is it Parmesan?
Sharp cheddar, but there's, I accidentally put double the jalapenos and double the cheese that I normally do, so I actually think that this whole, like right there, might all be cheese, but you know what?
That's so good. That means you get a big old bite of cheese.
Yeah, that's a dream, right? It just is gonna be a lot going on, but I think it's gonna be good.
Well, good, because they gave me like 4 slices of cheese out of this, so.
I can't wait. Oh, yeah. Wow. Oh, wow. You've got a lot.
Oh, yeah. I brought like stuff. Oh, yeah.
Stuff. Okay, good. Sandwich tutorial.
And.
This is huge. This is, what a collaboration between Spencer, myself, and Macy.
Yeah, but wait, what did Macy bring?
No, Macy brought herself.
Oh. Oh,
she's okay. But she's making the sandwiches. Macy, I just want to see a nice slice here.
Oh,
wow.
I know.
That's looking good.
Cheers.
Oh, cheers.
Cheers.
This is unreal.
Yeah, thanks, guys.
Oh, my God.
It's like actually really
good. So good.
Why are you guys acting so surprised? That's like my 18th loaf.
It's better than the first one, though.
That is so good.
The first one was really good.
Yeah, well, that's because of the jalapeno cheddar, though.
It's for the inside.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Wow. Macy, that presentation's insane. Macy, this looks so good.
Okay.
Wow.
Mustard.
We have lunch, our lunch break. Thanks to Macy. Are
you ready? The last 2 times they've seen me, my phone's been broken. I just died again.
Oh, no.
That's crazy.
Do you want a block?
Yeah.
That's
Tati has my vlog, so. I literally said in this vlog that like when people start eating on camera, I click off. But like, sorry.
Mm-mm.
We have to do a true taste test. Wow. This just like brought me back to my childhood for some reason. I just had a flashback.
Okay, show me the
rope. It's so good.
It's a pleasure doing business with you.
Are these Hatch chilies?
Look at how amazing my new needlepoint is. I've actually been hard at work needlepointing this week. I'm trying to finish a project because it's a gift and I have to get it finished, like sent in to get finished tomorrow. So it's gonna be a wild Friday night, staying home to finish this needlepoint project and staying up very late. But anyways, I love this one. I think I got it from, was it Wheelhouse Needlepoint? Yeah, Wheelhouse Needlepoint. One of y'all actually DM'd it to me and you were like, you have this. And I absolutely did. So anyways, I'm really excited to work on that one, even though I have my big Christmas one. That is just, is that ever gonna get done? Who knows? This is fun. It's fun to like break it up into smaller projects. I also ordered this self-tanner on TikTok shop because apparently it's like the only custom self-tanner and I saw really good reviews about it. I'm also watching Monsters, which is like loosely, I mean not loosely, but it's based off the Menendez brothers. I know there's definitely differences between like what really happened in the show. This is a case I haven't followed like super intensely. I've heard about it over the years and looked into it. It's really sad. I'm interested to hear what y'all think of the series and everything going on. I saw online this week that the brothers are reunited for the first time in like 20 years, so that's great, but it's really, really crazy. Anyways, I'm gonna take the next couple of hours, finish up work, and then back to Needlepoint, and that's it. Oh, guys, look at the garden. We've got some greens. They're growing a ton, actually. That's like really exciting.
I'm going out of town this weekend. I love y'all, and I will see you next week. My favorite drinks ever.